Before Jesus ascended into heaven, before he died and hung on the cross, he was with the disciples at the Last Supper. In Luke 22:33, we find Peter saying, "Lord, I'm ready to go with you to prison and to death." And Jesus replied, "I tell you, Peter, before the rooster crows today, you will deny three times that you know me." You see, Peter was unable to truly follow Jesus at that time. It wasn't until Jesus died for Peter that Peter realized he could die for Jesus. Follow Jesus is a call to literally give your life for the cause of Christ. Think about the fathers of the faith. Stephen was stoned. Barnabas was stoned. Matthias, stoned and beheaded. James the Greater was also beheaded. Paul, the man who persecuted and killed Christians, was transformed by the power of the cross and willingly gave his neck to the sword. Matthew, Simon, and Jude were all stabbed and hacked to death for the cause of Christ. And Thomas, the very man who doubted Jesus' resurrection, now had an unshakable faith that led him to preach the gospel throughout India, where he was murdered by the spear. Jesus, Brother James, was thrown off the temple wall, stoned and beaten by clubs until he died. Bartholomew was excoriated, was then skinned alive and beheaded for his faith in Jesus Christ. And Philip took up their crosses and were crucified, while Luke was crucified on an olive tree. That's not even all who gave their life to follow Jesus in death. Let us not forget about Peter. Peter, the one who couldn't walk on the water, the one who couldn't cast out the demon, the one who denied Christ, was transformed. And when his time came, Peter found himself unworthy to die in the same way as his Lord, and thus he was crucified upside down. Death.